making smash. I'm gonna smash the shit out of them.
You bring the flat of your axe down over the polyhedra, smashing them each into three little globs.
Three little globs.
But yet again, the chunks of jelly grow and shift until you're looking at a small army of six gelatinous polyhedra.
Damn it.
Where do you keep getting these?
A good game master is always prepared. The polyhedra engulf you, burning any exposed skin and searing your clothes.
No!
Take 12 damage.
I cast...
Which one? Both?
Ring of fire.
You send out a burst of fire, exploding the polyhedra into hundreds of tiny pieces.
No more, please. Temper tantrum? Rage roll? I'm not sure if temper tantrum is that useful. Rage roll?
let's try... Rage roll!
You curl up into an angry little elf ball and roll furiously around the caves.
Seriously.
Smashing each of the little jelly bits.
She's rolling
into
around.
Even more, even littler jelly bits.
I feel like we should run.
Run screaming.
Luckily, gelatinous polyhedra have a very low movement speed. The party flees safely, but the polyhedra aren't far behind.
All right.
You're near the exit of the caves when you run across...
The Dragonkin.
Oh, shit. Is that me?
You're gonna play?
Hell yeah.
Yeah, little brother.
Pavel, the arrogant gnome bard, joins your party.
Arrogant gnome bard? Gnome bard.
Gnome bard.
That's what she said.
Know any firewalk?
No, I don't know any of your shitty music.
Damn. Gnomes have very little bodies.
Why don't you pick on someone your own size? There's probably a squirrel somewhere that you can fight.
One she hasn't eaten.
I don't need violence to solve my problems. I just need the power of music.
Okay.
This is awesome.
Fine, but don't slow us down.
I got a Rush song in my head.
Been chatting. The army of gelatinous polyhedra has caught up to you.
Oh, jeez.
Several spew acid directly at Elamon. What do you do?
Shield him with the bard. Shield him with the bard.
grab the bard and use him to shield Elamon.
Whoa, hey. Can she do that?
Bard, sing away.
All's fair in love and tabletop. You whip the bard's little body back and forth, catching every spear as they fly at you. The gnome shrieks, perfect F sharp with every impact.
That was sick.
Oh my god. You're a monster.
You burst forth into the majestic meadow, horizon to horizon. All you can see is lush, green fields full of birds. Flowers.
Is the bard dead?
And dragonkin.
Yep.
What?
Instead of chasing you, they circle around to set a trap. And you just walked right into it. As the dragonkin ahead prepare to attack, the army of gelatinous polyhedra arrive behind you.
Jesus.
We're surrounded and screwed.
Fly
Come
us
on,
up.
Elamon. I'm sure you've got some sweet spell that'll save us.
Fly us all up, and let them take each other out.
Searing crystal.
Perfect! Searing crystal, these fuckers!
Which ones?
You don't get it. This isn't just another battle spell. This crystal is like dropping a nuke.
Huh.
It'll kill everything. Including you and me.
Actually, you did grab Durgeron's Bracer of Fire Immunity. Whoever wears it would survive.
See? Problem solved.
Well,
but there's only one bracer.
Exactly. Sacrifice me? I can't choose just Elamon. Notice that. I can't choose Elamon. Sorry, I was allowed. Sacrifice me. I'm going to choose sacrifice me so we can get into a verbal battle, of course. I know you guys want to see that.
Mikey loves his character. I can't just let him get Elamon killed.
Funny how we don't have the option to just have Elamon. I guess he wouldn't allow it, just out of... it should have been there and then gone back to the original choices, I think.
Elamon, keep the bracer and cast the spell. I'll hold them off so you can survive.
Oh, it is him. Never mind.
It won't work. Look at all of them. I should have never started this quest.
Don't mind me, guys. I didn't know what the hell.
I'm too weak. About.
You're stronger than Durgaron.
Elamon, you beat the shit out of Durgaron and took his bracelet.
Bracer.
Yeah, that.
Brace thing.
See, you can do anything.
But I've never even used this spell before. What if I roll too low?
I believe in you.
I believe in you. I know you'll roll high.
You're the only party member I've ever had who's actually helped me.
Really?
I can't leave you behind.
Who else has there been? You help everyone, Elamon.
You're, like, the most heroic person I know.
This has to work.
You help everyone. It's my turn to save you from something.
No,
no?
Calamastia, I won't just kill you.
Kill them, too.
You'll kill all of these monsters, too. Think of how many lives you'll be saving by nuking their stupid faces off.
That's right.
But I can save everyone. I know I can. Somehow.
It's not about you.
It's not about what you can and can't do. This is about the greater good. I know you'll make the right call.
No.
Did I
won't abandon the best partner I've ever had.
I never win these.
Mikey.
Damn it.
I cast Shield of Stars.
I never win those verbal things. Damn it.
A dome of blinding light surrounds the party. It captures the attention of all surrounding creatures. They immediately charge.
Like, oh, his face was right there. His face was behind the screen.
Stars withstand some of the blows, but wave after wave of attacks weakens it until...
Until?
The shield gives out. Dragonkin and gelatinous polyhedra descend upon the party.
Damn it.
Do we fight valiantly?
Oh, yeah. By fire and sword, you take many of them down, though there are always more to take their place.
Sounds like state last year.
Their numbers overwhelm you, hacking you to death, or burning you with acid, or both.
Thanks, DM.
Eventually, you die. Your body's torn to pieces.
Like, kick the
damn
Dragon Master shield.
Mikey, I'm really sorry.
Kick the DM shield.
I've been on for 3 years. He was like a friend.
Oh, damn
but
it.
You can create a new character, right?
Yeah. I guess.
Maybe Elamon had
then
a son.
Let's do this shit. How do we start?
Wait, really? You'll play with me?
Sure, why not? We're not gonna let those shitheads think that they're better than the North Brothers.
This is gonna be dope. That was a pretty intense one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thanks for playing. It always means a lot to Mikey.
Seems like the least I could do.
Too bad I didn't win the verbal battle. Damn it. It's not so obvious what to pick.
It's kind of nice that I can bum around here while I'm waiting for Rachel.
Yeah.
Steph and Drew aren't leaving Mikey's side. He's lucky to have them.
Say hi to Rachel for us.
We're rooting for her.
Okie doke. I'm gonna look at Teddy Bear.
That's cute. I guess.
Uh-huh. Mystic Bear. Flowers.
Huh. Those must be from Steph's parents.
George and Lita Gingrich. Hope these bring you some cheer. Oh, Graffiti the cast, yeah.
I barely knew Mikey 2 days ago, and now I feel kind of protective.
That bed looks way too big for him.
Thanks for playing, Chloe. That was one of the most emotional adventures I've ever had.
Next time, let me win the verbal battle, damn it.
Hey, can I sign your cast?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, sign it.
Something nerdy.
Calamastia.
But not too nerdy.
Calamastia. Armor. Bracer. Bracer of what, Durgaron?
There you go.
Cool.
Sweet. How'd we get him to turn his arm all the way around? Does he say anything different? Let's see.
I barely knew Mikey 2 days ago, and now I feel kind of protective.
Unfortunately, I can't skip ahead.
Thanks for playing, Chloe. That was one of the most emotional adventures I've ever had.
No problemo. Oh, which? Let's just see. Still got a bunch. Greasy gunk. Snack box. Unheeded warning in TA's desk. Check out the textbooks. Yay.
Oh, man. Did I miss the robot visit?
Geometry homework stuff. Read chapters. Due on Wednesday. Our robot sucks, man. We need you. Can we bring it tomorrow? I want to shoot a robot, too. Alright, we're done in here then. Nope, we really can't... Alright.
Hey. Wait up a sec.
Yeah?
Sorry I got angry at you yesterday. About the money. You were just trying to help.
It's alright. I was helping myself. It's okay.
Don't worry about it. You were in a really tough situation.
A situation I created.
Yeah,
when you said that Damon stabbed Rachel, I kept thinking, I'm supposed to look out for Mikey, not bring this shit into his life.
True.
I think you saved us from something so much worse. Thank you.
Yeah, sure.
Thanks for stopping by.
Bye, Chloe.
Bye. That was awesome, though. I was hoping we'd have another D&D adventure. James Amber. Chloe, this is Mr. Amber. Rachel is just waking up now. I'm sure she'd love to see you. Thanks. And it is 2:02 p.m. Alright. Anything else to look at on the way, though? Yes, of course there is. Shh. What's it say?
More like silent hospital slowly drive friends and family insane.
Silent hospitals help healing. Yeah, sometimes. Staff only. Open up!
Hey. Just heard the fire went out.
Went out? You mean it's controlled?
No. It's completely out. It extinguished itself.
Oh, how good.
Could it be? Hell if I know.
It's the power of Rachel Amber, because she...
I'm so relieved that Rachel's awake.
Yeah.
I should see her right away.
just a moment because I am having a profound... She has special pyrokinetic powers, and because she's unconscious, the fire stopped. That's all part of her drama, you know, see. She's not even aware she's doing it. Look at firefighters.
Those guys look exhausted.
And dirty. Oh. Hippo? What's it say?
Rachel's unless you get stabbed.
Eating the right foods keeps you healthy and happy. Glad I interrupted her annoying me about Rachel again. I'm looking around, damn you. Was it? Is that Rachel's room? It is Rachel's room. Rose? Okay, let me just look at the sign, because that's important. Stop, no visitors.
No visitors. Huh?
Wait.
Why has my son been assigned to you? I never authorized...
What's this?
I was assigned because Nathan was becoming quite upset.
So they sent a psychiatrist. Because my son was upset.
Oh, Nathan's in the hospital too? Shit.
Please, Mr. Prescott, your son needs serious psychiatric...
My son needs nothing from you. He put down a couple of bullies who were harassed.
I'm so relieved that Rachel's awake.
Shh.
I should see her right away.
We're listening to the thing.
I believe your son is manifesting serious and alarming symptoms.
Hmm, yep.
Allow me the chance to...
Nathan's already getting more than enough attention from one of you. I am fed up with these made-up problems.
Hey! I gotta open it.
Rachel's probably waiting for me.
Let me open her door. I want to hear... Okay, never mind. Nah, I'm just gonna leave, you know, so... I don't know. Just look at and talk to Rose first.
Wow. Rachel's mom does not look okay.
I wouldn't look okay if I were Rachel's mom or Rachel's mostly mom.
Hey.
Aw. I'm like part of the family now.
Chloe. I can't even express thank you so much. I'm sorry. I'm a wreck. I stepped out to get some air. Rachel doesn't need me crying in front of her.
Hmm.
Your hair. I almost didn't notice it.
Almost.
Oh. Yeah. It's not a big deal.
I bet Rachel loves it.
Hmm.
I can't imagine what I would do if we lost her.
Well, I don't know what to tell you about that, because someday... Yeah, she thinks my hair is hot. It's going to be fine.
I'm sure everything's going to be fine.
That's what James keeps saying. He's so strong in a crisis, you know?
Probably.
My dad was like that.
Probably an act.
I'm sure he was. Just like his daughter.
Put up the tough guy act. We were lucky. Who was lucky? To have dad? Yeah, I guess so. I think that's what she means.
I just keep feeling like...
Oh.
We were lucky.
No, they were lucky today.
It could have gone so much worse.
Yeah,
I'm sure it would have been.
I thought he stabbed her right in the heart.
I am so glad you and Rachel have found each other. When you meet someone who changes everything, you just know.
Oh, does she know it's like one of friends?
There. This is Amber.
I will.
Does she have a feeling this is not completely platonic? The way she said that, you know?
Rachel's mom loves her so much.
Hmm?
I'm sure Rachel can't wait to see you.
Yep, I've left her waiting long enough. First of all, just look at the door.
I'm gonna just walk into Rachel's room. Try and stop me, nurses. I'm so glad Rachel's okay. Really can't wait to see her.
Well, we've been waiting to see her because I've been looking at everything, so let's go.
Dad.
The little socks.
I'm glad that you're here.
Me too, Rachel.
It really hurts.
Shh. Owie.
The pain will pass.
Morphine. Morphine drip.
Clone nurse. Here. You want me to stay?
Nah, I get the hell out.
No. I'll be okay. Thanks, Dad.
I'll come back in a little while.
Good thing you touched that shoulder and not her other one. She would have smacked you.
My guardian angel.
Steph says hey.
I saw Steph earlier. She says hey. Steph's so cute, but not as cute as you.
Aww.
Stop. I mean it.
Aww.
Rachel, I'm sorry. What? What for? You're here because of me. Because I choked back there in the junkyard. What? Shut up. You were so fierce and I just froze. God, I fucked it up. I'm so sorry. And you saved my life. You saved my life.
I almost lost you.
I almost lost you. I can't believe I almost...
You're not getting rid of me that easy.
Good. Happy that your dad's here?
I mean... I'm still mad at him for everything he's done. But it felt so good to lean on him. He's my dad, you know? I felt completely safe.
Like on Mount Hood.
Would you do something for me?
Anything.
I was gonna say anything.
Sarah. My mom.
Get a hold of her.
It's so weird to say. I'm not even sure what she is, honestly. But I think I still want to meet her.
I figured you would. I really did, because, I don't know. Maybe we can do it in a safer way? Maybe convince her dad to actually, you know, hook them up in a controlled setting, you know, where they'll be nearby. Nothing terrible will happen, and then people can step in and help. Rather than having to go through drug dealers and track her down and get in trouble, get stabbed and stuff like that. You know, it's all that's terribly exciting, but, you know, it's a little easier to not go that route. So yeah, I figured you would, but I'd like to find a valid way to do so.
I figured you would.
I don't even know if she's still in Arcadia Bay.
She was last night.
But if she is, will you find her, please?
You really want this, don't you?
I do, Chloe. I really do.
Okay.
Then, of course,
Whatever it takes.
Well, not too frank.
My dad has her number. Maybe probably in his office.
Yeah?
Our house key's just under the mat.
Huh.
The code is 0722.
Rag it down.
To your dad's office? 0722.
I wrote it down.
Yeah.
Just in case.
My birthday.
Oh.
I'll find her, Rachel. And then I'll tell her how fucking cool you are.
Don't punch her back.
Thank you, Chloe. For everything.
To go CP. As long as we don't hear no beep, that'd be terrible. So I have to break into their house now? Well, sort of. With a key. Aw. So cute. Oh, freaking Nathan Prescott. Oh, that's Elliot. Never mind.
Hey, Elliot.
Hey. Wait. Your hair, it's different.
Yeah. Color, you know?
Yeah. Yeah.
I like it. It's nice. I like your shirt, too. I don't think I've ever seen you wear that before.
It's new.
Keeping tabs on what I wear.
Who's that for? Is that for Rachel, or what's his name, the kid? Nice balloon.
Nice balloon.
I guess that's right, for Rachel then.
Yeah.
Oh.
It's for Mikey. Were you just in there?
I stand corrected.
I'm actually here for Rachel.
What? Rachel's here?
Oh, he doesn't know.
What happened?
Go get another balloon. That's a long story. Yeah, she's keeping it private.
I think she's keeping that private for now. She's okay, though.
We don't want everyone knowing.
That's good.
I don't know how this kid...
I guess I'll stop by. After I see Mikey.
She probably wants privacy.
Oh.
What about that?
Right, of course.
We're so protective.
Are you two in some kind of trouble? You can tell me if you are, you know. I won't judge.
What do you mean?
What? I don't even know what you mean.
It's kind of weird that Rachel's being so private. Isn't it?
Think so?
No. It's really not.
Yeah.
Chloe. I'm seriously worried about you.
Well, don't be.
Yeah, calm down, dude.
I mean, you're hanging out with Rachel Amber a lot lately. Right?
So what?
Uh-huh. So, obviously, something is going on.
Well, we're like lesbian lovers and stuff. What do you want? It's really okay.
I swear, man. Everything's really okay.
Okay. I trust you.
You better.
Just remember I'm here, okay? If you suddenly need something.
Thanks. Suddenly? Anyway, see you around.
Yeah. See you around, Chloe.
He's so awkward. He's like, the way he said that, he's like, you suddenly need something. He's gonna be a snoop-a-doop, isn't he? He's still staring at her. Well, I feel like a jerk. They're in the hospital. We're out of their minds still about what's going on. And here I am going to their house without their permission.
Hello?
Stove's not on, is it? Oven? No, stove. Oh, I didn't have to write down the code, huh? That's way too obvious to make it her birthday. I mean, she's like amateur hour. Is that our own phone?
I need to search this office for any communication with Sarah that can help me find her.
Okay. Well, a phone went off. I guess it's not ours. Let me check. Oh, I got another page. Yeah, no texts. I don't think you know how you feel about someone until you almost lose them. Until you sit in a hospital waiting room, frozen in place, yet somehow falling, silently, desperately pleading to hear their voice, touch their hand, make them laugh. Then you know. It was weird being with Rachel's dad, and actually kind of nice. We were on the same team, suddenly, and none of the other shit mattered. I think I can see why Rachel loves him. Got to check in on Mikey, spend some time with him and staff. Oh yeah, and cheer Mikey up with some more hardcore nerd gaming. That was awesome. After what felt like forever, Rachel woke up. Even with everything that's happened, she's still focused on finding her mother. So I am too. Here's the plan. I'm going to dig around James' office, find whatever I can about her, and track her down so they can meet. I don't care how tough it might be. Chloe, the bounty hunter. I love the little theme that plays when you go into the journal. Snow globe?
If it can rain ash, I guess it could snow in LA.
True. So somehow, I don't think this is going to reveal her phone number, but what? Point of view from folders? Oh, I was like, what is that?
Big one.
It's that spell, the nuke spell, went off.
James has a file on Frank.
Ooh.
I'd love to read this, but I've got to focus on finding Rachel's mom.
No, I want to read it. Read. Damn it. Dad Award.
Best dad.
Naked.
That stuff is all politics anyway. Hmm.
Oh, yeah, someone went chink-a-chink in there. Oh, might be a key for that drawer. Locked drawer behind me. Oh, I love the sound of that. It sounds like treasure.
Sweet. A secret key.
Hehe.
Now to find the secret lock.
It's right there on the desk.